Hey, mathematics learners, welcome to Distance Learning with Lee, where I make learning mathematics super easy. So on today's video tutorial, guys, we're just going to be looking at eight questions where we are basically going to be converting between the different units of length, right? I basically did a live yesterday where I was introducing you guys to the topic, right? And during the live, guys, I did mention that when you want to move from a bigger unit of measurement, okay, or bigger unit, okay, to a smaller unit of measurement, we are supposed to multiply, right? And if you move from a smaller unit of measurement to a bigger unit of measurement, you are supposed to divide, okay? And, you know, I think this activity is great to just help you guys see what I mean when I talk about a bigger unit of measurement for length and a smaller unit of measurement for length. Why are kilometers, like, you know, the bigger unit of measurement, and why are millimeters the smaller unit of measurement? Okay, if you look at this activity here, right, it says there are four pictures below. Decide on the most appropriate unit of length for each situation. Okay, so we're going to decide, would it be most appropriate to measure the length of this petal using millimeters or centimeters or kilometers or meters? Would it be appropriate to, which unit of measurement would be the most appropriate for us to measure the length of this caterpillar? Would it be kilometers? Would it make sense for us to measure the length of this caterpillar using kilometers, using meters, using centimeters, using millimeters, and why? Okay, would it be appropriate, which units of length would be the most appropriate for us to measure the length of this bench? Would it be kilometers? Would it be meters? Would it be centimeters? Would it be millimeters, and why? And which unit of measurement would be, which unit of length, okay, would be the most appropriate for us to measure the distance from Cape Town to Johannesburg? Okay, so when we basically look at this flower, the petal of a really small flower, guys, okay, which unit of length would be the most appropriate for us to measure that length of that petal? Okay, would it make sense for us to measure the length of a petal in millimeters? Okay, or would it be most appropriate for us to measure it in centimeters? Okay, you'd see that if you're really measuring the length of, you know, something that is really, really small, guys, okay, like a small flower's petal, it would be appropriate for us to measure that length in millimeters. Okay, why is that so? You'll see, guys, that when you actually have a look at your ruler, okay, and you have a look at the millimeter side, okay, you'll see that the millimeter side has more like your smaller and younger divisions there, okay, which makes it possible for you to even measure an object that is really, really small, because you can account for that small length, okay, right? Okay, you'll find that with 1 centimeter, okay, is equal to 10 millimeters, right? So if you actually measure in millimeters, you'll be able to account for like a small object or something that is really small, okay? And in this case, because we can see that, okay, this flower's petal, okay, is really small, if you were to measure this in millimeters, you'd be able to accurately get the length of that petal. But if you try to measure it in centimeters, you end up having to like approximate and be like, okay, it's roughly 1 point, you know, something. But if you measured it in millimeters, you'd be able to accurately get the correct length of this petal. Okay, so the unit of measurement that we would be the most appropriate, okay, for us to measure the length of this petal would be millimeters. Okay, now let's have a look at number two. Which unit of measurement would be the most appropriate to measure the length of a caterpillar? So we know that, okay, a caterpillar is, you know, longer than a flower's petal, okay, a really small flower's petal, okay, so it would be more appropriate, okay, it would make much more sense for us to measure the length of this caterpillar using centimeters. Okay, we would be able to really get an accurate measure of length of this caterpillar using centimeters. Okay, let's have a look at this length of this wooden bench. Which unit of measurement would be the most appropriate for us to measure the length, of this bench? Okay, so we know that, I mean, if you think of, the benches that we see in the parks and things like that, these are actually, slightly, they are actually longer than a caterpillar, longer than a flower's petal, okay? So we can see that, okay, the unit of measurement that would be the most appropriate for us to measure the length of a bench would be meters, okay? It would make much more sense to measure the length of this bench in meters, all right? You can literally take a measuring tape and measure that bench in meters. And then let's have a look here. Which unit of measurement would be the most appropriate to measure the distance between Cape Town and Johannesburg? So guys, Cape Town is far, okay? Very far from Johannesburg, okay? We can't measure the distance between these two cities in meters. Okay, it wouldn't be appropriate for us to use meters, okay, to measure the distance from Cape Town to Johannesburg, but it would be appropriate for us to use kilometers. It wouldn't be appropriate for us to use centimeters, guys, and it wouldn't be appropriate for us to use millimeters. That is too small. Centimeters is too small. Meters is also too small, okay? But it makes more sense to measure distances from one town to another, one province to another, and things like that in kilometers. So that is why what I mean by bigger units of measurement to a smaller unit of measurement. We use millimeters usually to represent, something that is really small, to measure the length of something that is really small. We use kilometers to measure the distance of something that is really, really big, great, okay? Like the distance from one town to another, we usually use kilometers. For me to go from, Boksburg to Germiston, okay? You would measure the distance in kilometers, okay? So that is what I mean by if you move from a bigger unit of measurement to a smaller unit of measurement, okay? That is basically what I'm talking about. Your millimeters is a unit of measurement that is used to measure really, really tiny things, like a grain of rice, okay? Like the diameter of your earrings and things like that, okay? But we use your meters to like measure, a length of a door, length of a bench, things like that. We use centimeters to maybe measure a person's height, the length of a caterpillar, and things like that. Okay, so I hope that everyone now understands what I'm talking about when I say that. Okay, so how do we move from kilometers to meters? I've already spoken about this in my live, guys, so please make sure that you really support that live as well. Just watch it, okay? Really watch it, write the questions down and just try them out on your own, okay? It's a really a great way for you to practice and see if you're able to convert between the different units of length. Okay, so from kilometers to meters, we already know that if you're moving from a bigger to a smaller, you multiply. Okay, so from kilometers to meters, you multiply by 1,000. From meters to centimeters, you multiply by 100. From centimeters to millimeters, you multiply by 10. And at the bottom, guys, remember you do the inverse operation of what we did at the top. So because at the top we were multiplying by 10, at the bottom we will divide by 10. At the top we were multiplying by 100, at the bottom we will divide by 100. At the top we were multiplying by 1,000, at the bottom we will divide by 1,000. Okay, and then we are just going to be now using this diagram to help us answer the questions that are given to us. Okay, so please just take a minute, take a screenshot of these questions, right? Try them out on your own, then play the video tutorial, guys, to check to see if you were able to convert between these different units of length. Okay, so the first one, we're converting from kilometers to meters. Okay, I'm just gonna do the first one with you guys really slowly. Okay, we are moving from kilometers to meters. Okay, so what are we supposed to do in this case, guys? Nice and simple. We're supposed to multiply by 1,000. So all that we're gonna do then, we're gonna take that 38. Okay, we're gonna take the 38 kilometers, and we are just gonna multiply by 1,000. If you multiply by the 38 by 1,000, you're just gonna have 38,000 meters. Question 1.2. Want to convert 1,765 meters to kilometers. Now, in this case, right, what are we doing? We are basically moving from the smaller units, meters, okay, to the bigger units, kilometers. So what are we supposed to do in this case? If you're moving from a smaller unit to a bigger unit, remember, guys, you're moving from the right to the left. So we're gonna divide by 1,000. So all that we're gonna do, we're just gonna take that 1,765 meters. We're gonna divide by 1,000. If you divide by 1,000, guys, we've got three zeros. So that basically means that we're going to move our pointer there three times. So it's gonna be one, two, three. Then that's your comma. So therefore, our answer is going to be 1.765 kilometers, right? Question 1.3. We want to convert 855 meters to centimeters. So now, where are we? We are currently at meters, right? We are here. We want to go to centimeters. So we're moving from a bigger unit, okay, to a smaller unit. What do we do? Multiply by 100. So all that we're going to do here, we're going to take that 855 meters. We're going to multiply by 100. If you multiply by 100, simply add two zeros to this 855. So it's going to be 85,000. Okay, 85,500. All right, so that will be our final answer there. So let's have a look at question 1.4. Okay, let's have a look at question 1.4. With question 1.4, guys, we have to convert centimeters to meters. Okay, so where are we? We're at centimeters. We want to go to meters. So what are we going to do? Nice and easy. We're moving from the right, going to the left, from the smaller units to the bigger units. We are just going to be dividing by 100. Okay, so we're going to say 1.4. Okay, we want to convert 1,289 centimeters to meters. So all that we're going to do, we're going to divide by 100. Okay, so if you divide by 100, okay, your answer, our pointer is currently here, right? Or our comma is currently here. We're going to move it two spaces to the left. So it's going to be one, two, and that is where I'm going to put my comma. So the answer is 12.89 meters. Okay, question 1.5. Question 1.5 says that we need to convert 3.4 kilometers to centimeters. Okay, so we are currently where? We are currently here, kilometers, right? That is where we are. We want to go to centimeters. That is where we want to go. So what do you want to do? Remember, we're moving from the left to the right, from the bigger unit to the smaller unit. So we're going to first multiply by 1,000. Okay, then we are going to multiply by 100, because if we just multiply by 1,000, that just puts us at meters. So we need to continue and still multiply by 100. So basically, if we want to convert kilometers to centimeters, we're going to multiply by 1,000, then multiply by 100. Okay, so we're going to do that. We are going to take the 3.4 kilometers, right? Multiplied by 1,000, multiplied by 100. What do we see here, guys? This is the same as us just multiplying by 10,000. Do you see that? If you take 1,000 multiplied by 100, you'll see, if you take 1,000 and multiply it by 100, you'll see that that is the same as just multiplying by 100,000. So you can even just write it as 3.4 kilometers multiplied by 1,000 and 100. So you can put a 1 and put how many zeros? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so do you see that that is the same as us just multiplying by 100,000? Okay, so this is basically the same thing. This is the same thing, okay, right? And if you do that, you'll get that your answer is, okay, 340,000 centimeters. Okay, same thing, guys, 340,000 centimeters. So you can either do it like this or like that. That would be absolutely correct. Question 1.6. Question 1.6, guys, we are converting centimeters to kilometers. Go to our diagram, okay? Okay, so in question 1.6, guys, we want to convert centimeters to kilometers. So where are we currently? We at centimeters. We want to convert centimeters, and we are currently here, and we want to go there. So what are we supposed to do? Supposed to then divide by 100, then we're supposed to divide by 1,000. Okay, so let's do that. I'm going to take that 1,950 centimeters, right? We're going to divide by 100, divide by 1,000. I already explained, guys, this is the same as just dividing by 100,000. Okay, you basically will get the same answer. Okay, so therefore, remember, we're going to move our pointer or our comma 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 spaces to the left, or you can just use your calculator. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so your answer will be 0. So your answer will be 0.1985. Okay, answer will be 0.1985 kilometers. Okay, let's have a look at question 1.7. Question 1.7, guys, we are required to convert centimeters to millimeters. So where are we currently? At centimeters, we want to go to millimeters. Okay, so what do we do here? We're moving from the bigger units to the smaller units. We are just going to multiply by 10. Okay, so it'll be 2,850 millimeters. The last question, guys, question 1.8, we are required to convert millimeters to centimeters. So where are we now? Okay, we are currently at millimeters, so that is where we're at. We want to go to centimeters, so we're moving from a smaller unit to the bigger unit. Okay, so in this case, we are just going to be dividing by 10. Okay, and that will give you 96.5 centimeters. All right. And that is it, guys, for today's video tutorial when it comes to converting between the different units of measurement for length, right? In the next video tutorial, guys, I'm going to be taking you through what you guys or ways that will help you convert between the metric system of measurement to the imperial system of measurement and vice versa. Okay, I'll show you guys an amazing method. Or anyway, just an amazing way that you can think of how you can convert maybe inches to meters and things like that. Okay, so please make sure that you watch that video tutorial. Please don't forget to like this video tutorial if you made it this far. Please don't forget to share this video tutorial with your friends, and I'll see you guys on my next upload.
That is it, guys, and I'll see you guys on my next upload, Distance Learning with Lee, where I make learning mathematics super easy. Bye. Thank you.